sinner. I ain't some beginner. I'm gonna uncork me a pint of trouble, and I'll sit down and drink a double. I'm thirsty for something lighter that could get me even tighter and tighter till someday I swear I hear angels play. Goodness, is it really real? It would take a child to know the way I feel. Oh my, floating in the blue. I could take the credit, but it's thanks to you.
Everybody out there tonight.
They're all raising heck out there, I can tell you right now.
Yeah, you know, the cool weather moved in. It does make you a little crazy, doesn't it?
We got wild, wacky Mr. Phil here.
We have, yes.
On national TV.
That's right. Yeah. Famous Mr. Phil, thank you for joining us.
And listen what we got here. Our sponsor.
Look at that.
Roy Homer. I say that every time. Roy's Corner at Homer's. And I was up there today and had my clam chowder fix.
You did?
Wow. Yeah.
Oh, good, good.
Okay. We get Texas Wiener from the man. He makes 24 toppings.
Yeah.
And his dogs are only a buck a piece.
Yeah, it's amazing.
So we'll probably eat some of these.
No. Oh, no.
Right.
Yeah.
It's 2 East Main Street. Stop in and tell them that we sent you from Keeping Country Strong.
Right. Yes. That's right. Yeah.
And he's going to sponsor our hot dog eating contest November 4th here. If you'd like to get on it, it's $20 donation if you want to eat them.
Mm-hmm.
$5 donation if you want to come in and see everybody.
Yes.
I know you can't wait.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Now, how about the party we went to with Don Orioli?
Oh, my gosh. Oh, well, I have to tell you, if you're ever in the area, he plays a lot out in the Sussex County area in New Jersey. And when I say gets that place rocking and rolling.
Here's the Don.
It's absolutely a fantastic night.
Man.
It's unbelievable. He has several other people that are on stage with him, and each one is just a mega talent. And I'm not joking. It's really,
really Did you know who the bass player was?
I know he's somebody pretty famous. I forget, though.
Black Eyed Peas.
Ah, that's what it was. Okay, I knew. I remembered him announcing that.
And he was in that song, Play a Funky White Boy.
White Boy, mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean,
and he plays them all the time.
Does
what
he
a
really?
Great bass player.
Oh my gosh, the music was just amazing. I'm telling you. So if you know, it's called Felix and the Cats, and
they play so many songs. I can't believe it. All them old rock songs.
But that's because they're just all so talented, and they've been doing this.
Well, he don't even take a break. He sings.
No,
right
he doesn't.
Break.
That's right. Yeah, he doesn't even. Yeah. That's right, yep.
So I made friends with him a while ago here, and he just always says, come on out and sing with my band. It's a pleasure to sing with them. They're all pros.
Right, they are, yeah, yeah.
And they fooled me because they learned Folsom Prison Blues. He goes, are you going to sing that? I goes, yeah, I know it. Okay, let's do it.
Yeah.
And we tore the place up.
Yes,
and,
you did.
And we had
yeah.
a ball eating somebody else's food, and it was...
Yeah, and I do have to give her a call, actually.
I would give her a call. We ate your sandwich.
She gave us the okay. We just didn't dive
her
in on
her and
it.
My wife ate the ladies' food, chips and dip and everything there. It's like, I come over there after singing with Don's band. They're over there eating rolls. And I was like, wait a minute.
I'm like, here, there's a bag of chips. I'm like, here, help yourself.
Have half a sandwich.
No, she was really fantastic.
No, she was good. And I've got a lot of replies from Sussex because I know a lot of people in Sussex. I'm actually from New Fallon. So.
Oh, that's right. Okay, yeah.
So I knew a lot of people, and one lady wanted to buy my cowboy hat.
Oh, wow.
So I said, no, I got that one in Nashville. And we might go back to Nashville.
Yes, I know you might.
That's a big thing. And they're begging me now.
When are they talking about getting you back out there?
They didn't give me a date, but they're begging. They want me to move down there. Oh. If I moved down there, I'd be playing every night.
Yeah, wow.
You could almost make a living at this stuff.
Yeah.
And we might, now this is different news, we might get on a Nashville access station through our promoter down there. And if that works, we're in down in Nashville.
Wow.
He might do a show himself and send it up here and we'll air it here.
Oh, that's a great idea, yeah.
And his name's Howie. You got to see this guy. He sent me up pictures with some of the stars he was with. It was like Pure Prairie Lake.
Uh-huh.
He was with them guys. He was Randy Travis. I mean, all sitting at the same table. It wasn't like far away.
Right.
And there was another band. I can't think of the name of them, but he's there. When you're there, you meet all these people.
Right. That's right. Yeah.
I mean, we got in to see Mo Bandy, which was great.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He just says, I'm coming in. He let everybody in to go watch the show.
Wow. Wow. That's nice.
And that's where my grandson found out about moonshine.
Did he?
Oh, yeah. He was in another county.
Yeah. Well, that's where you're going to find it.
Well, we might get down there and play. I don't know. Yeah. Maybe next fall we'll move down there, but I don't know because everybody gets nervous if I tell them I'm moving because I'm running so many things up here.
Right.
And I also, for all the bands out there, I'm going to be running music in the park, free music in the park, and Madame Morris again on Tuesday nights. They already called me, and I'm going to book all the bands for it.
That's great.
So a lot of them are coming back, and it's a fun time, 6 to 8 on a Tuesday night.
Yeah, you can't beat it. And it's all summer long, right?
Right. And we didn't mind playing there because we had 100 and some people there. So I might get Don to do something where we both bands play.
Well, that'd be nice. That'd be...
You know, so...
Yeah, that's something you shouldn't miss.
Well, I got it all over Facebook, so.
Yeah, I mean,
playing with him.
Yeah, it's just amazing.
So, and what have you been doing with yourself, old timer?
Okay, I've been doing different.
Keep talking. I got to have the rest of this hot dog here.
Stuff like that.
You never seen a show like this, did you? Where you're eating hot dogs all night? It's great.
Yeah, last night I was at our station in Brooklyn. They had a big party over there. For the shows that we have, and they really said that, you know, we're doing a great job up here, and the shows that we supply them down there, and we're well liked in Brooklyn. And
he was just down there, and they said they like our shows.
That's great, wonderful.
In all seriousness, what they said about us, that we run our shows as a public access.
Hey, Manhattan and Brooklyn.
Yeah, that's right.
We run it as if it was a network, regular network show.
Yeah, how many people eat hot dogs on a show? It's got to be something.
but you know, they like us down there, and I met people from the other shows down there. And I spent the day also in MNN submitting my shows and uploading them for the next quarter. And got a chance to socialize and talk with these other folks down there that have shows. And I was talking to somebody who has a variety show down there. And it's just the way, the difference between, like, they'll handle it the way it's from Manhattan. And that's all they really have to do. While we're handling it for so many areas.
Down there, it's on three different channels.
Right.
So, you know, sometimes they air my show on Saturdays, too.
Oh, wow.
Right.
So let them play them. Play them to death.
Right, yeah. Why not?
So it's hillbillies up here. We love it.
But they do a wonderful station, both of them, MNN and Brick. And I thank them for giving us the coverage for the last few years.
Very nice.
They're just wonderful folks. And
I called her up once, and I said to her, how's my show going in there? And she said, did anybody call and cancel? I says, no. And don't worry about it. I says, all right, well, whatever.
That's
great. And if I can get in Nashville, then we're going to cover that, but right. We got a lot of people interested in doing stuff.
Mm-hmm. That's, yeah.
So you'll be down in Nashville, too.
I'll go, yeah.
Wow.
So
yeah.
We're going. The only reason we like Nashville is because they like my music there. I fit in.
Well, you do. It's a perfect, it really is a perfect venue for you.
You know. So maybe Hotel 6 in the Broken Spoke Saloon will have us back down there.
Yeah. Yeah.
We're talking about a lot of different things, and now the whole band wants to go. Hap, I want to move down here with me. I'll take them.
Why not?
And I got to thank my drummer. He went out and got our fuel pump for our Winnebago that somebody gave me.
Oh, wasn't that nice? So well.
So we're gonna get that put in, get that thing running, and then we're gonna gut the whole thing,
right,
and remodel it the way we want it inside.
Oh wow!
Wow,
that's a project.
And then we can take that to, well. People want to help me.
Yeah. Oh, that's good.
And then
good.
We might take it to Lake George, and because we want to play up there at some big resort that wants us.
That's right.
Oh, wow.
And we can just take it there in the campground.
Yeah.
Stay right in the trailer.
Yeah.
That's great. I mean.
Well, it's not a trailer. It's a,
Right. So
like a Winnebago.
Does it have? It has AC and it has. Yeah. So what the heck? Yeah.
So the lady who gave it to me, he's got all new carpet for it.
Oh, wow.
We're going to have it to power washed and check the roof out if it leaks anywhere.
Right.
And go from there.
Oh, that's great.
Tell us how it is in Nashville, the country music. Is it?
Well, there's areas down there that play rock and roll and newer country. And the one street, I don't know what they call that street, but. And they have that there, but the hardcore Nashville wants to hear Hank Williams, Johnny Cash, and all that. And guess what? That's the stuff I sing. So.
Wow, that's great.
And you do it well,
but,
too.
But I got to tell you, I took my grandson. He's never really come out to hear us do much.
Mm-hmm.
And we did the second set. It was 200 people there from the hotel.
Wow.
And the last song, we got a standing ovation, and my grandson goes, do another one. I says, nah, leave them hanging.
Yeah,
plus the ladies
right.
from Ireland were there.
That's great. Yeah, the ones and, that knew your song, right?
So I go out and say hi to everybody, and they go, I said, well, I got a song in Ireland, but you don't hear nothing else. I don't know. It was number one for 10 weeks, and they go, we know it.
That's amazing.
These five young ladies,
isn't that something?
Yeah, really.
And they knew the words and everything. I was like, wow.
That's...
And then my band's going, I'm going to go wherever you go.
That's true.
Because we might, me and Daryl might, let's say, go to Europe in London in January.
Oh, wow.
And sing over there. So we're busy.
Yeah.
Yeah,
wow.
That's wonderful.
Then we got to talk about, we're having the telethon, the 21st of this month.
That's right.
And Phil and hopefully you. And
right.
Somebody's always going to MC it, and we're going to have mostly people playing acoustic guitars and like that kind of music. There's a couple of members do karaoke, but the karaoke telethon he does.
Right.
It's in spring.
Right.
So we get all the karaoke singers to come out for
come
that.
Come out
like
for that.
This young lady we got here, she'd be great for that.
Right, right. That's
we got a lot of people play acoustic guitars and stuff. And,
that's going to be great.
You can watch and maybe make a little donation. We're looking to get some new cameras here.
That would be wonderful, yes.
And we have food and everything if you just
want
to stop
in. And some microphones. We need microphones, too.
Yeah.
But
well, we can always get them from Al's. He's a sponsor of the station.
Uh-huh.
We got a lot of good sponsors, Bruno's and Neversink Lumber, and we just picked up Stewie's.
Right, yeah.
It's all done.
Did she, because...
I went over it with her.
Oh, you did, okay.
She just wanted a few changes. Okay, she loved it.
Right,
she just wanted the pictures, like big pictures of the food.
Okay.
So that's what Tom did.
Okay, good.
And we're going to send it to her, and then... We'll start playing it.
Great, great, good. I'm glad. Yeah.
So, the station's here for everybody. But we really don't try to push new people to record shows here.
Right.
Just if they got a finished copy. We let them play outside. We have a machine out there. You can play it over the air out there.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully, we can get the mayor, Kelly Decker, to come down to our telethon. Maybe he'll come down and eat some hot dogs.
Yes.
Oh, there you go.
So we always like to have the mayor here. So all right, we got our singer here.
Excellent. Yes, Mr. Phil, do you want to introduce her?
Wait till she gets over there. Don't rush her, Phil. We want her to feel relaxed. But hold on, because I got to have another bite of this great hot dog from Roy's. My God, they're good.
Okay.
Earlier this year, Mary and I met this singer we're going to have on tonight, Natasha Rodriguez, at our clubs. And she is fabulous. And we've already had her open with God Bless America on my anniversary show this year, as you remember. And I want to introduce Natasha Rodriguez.
All right.
Hi, guys. How are you doing tonight? My name is Natasha, as you heard. The first song that I will be singing for you today is Love Yourself by Justin Bieber. Maybe you heard of him. I don't know. For all the times that you ran on my parade, and all the claps you get in using my name, you think you broke my heart, oh girl, for goodness sake. You think I'm crying on my own, well I ain't. And I didn't want to write a song, cause I didn't want anyone thinking I still care, I don't. But you still hit my phone up, and baby, I'll be moving on. And I think you should be something I don't wanna hold back. Maybe you should know that my mama don't like you, and she likes everyone. And I never like to admit that I was wrong. And I've been so caught up in my job, didn't see what's going on, and now I know. How about I sleep in on my own? Cause if you like the way you look that much, oh baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself. And when you told me that you hated my friends, the only problems was with you and not them. And every time you told me my opinion was wrong, and tried to make me forget where I came from. And I didn't want to write a song, cause I didn't want anyone thinking I still care, I don't. But you still hit my phone up, and baby, I'll be moving on. And I think you should be something I don't wanna hold back. Maybe you should know that my mama don't like you, and she likes everyone. And I never like to admit that I was wrong. And I've been so caught up in my job, didn't see what's going on, and now I know. How about I sleep in on my own? Cause if you like the way you look that much, oh baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself. For all the times that you made me feel small, I fell in love, now I feel nothing at all. I never felt so low when I was vulnerable. Was I a fool to let you break down my walls? Cause if you like the way you look that much, oh baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself. Cause if you like the way you look that much, much. Oh, baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself. Thank you. So this next song that I will be singing, the artist is Kelly Clarkson, or the very first American Idol winner. This one isn't one of her more popular songs, but I found it on, I think it was her second studio album. It's called A Beautiful Disaster.
He drowned in his dreams, an exquisite extreme, I know. He's as damned as he seems, more heaven than a heart could hold. And if I try to save him, my whole world would cave in. It just ain't right. No, just ain't right. Oh, and I don't know what he's after, but he's so beautiful. He's such a beautiful disaster. And if I could hold on through the tears and the laughter, Lord, would it be beautiful or just a beautiful disaster? He's magic and myth, as strong as what I believe. A tragedy with more damage than a soul should see. But do I try to change him, so I'm not to blame him? Hold me tight, baby, hold me tight. Oh, and I don't know what he's after, but he's so beautiful. He's such a beautiful disaster. And if I could hold on through the tears and the laughter, Lord, would it be beautiful or just a beautiful disaster? I'm longing for love and the logical, that he's only half hysterical. I'm searching for some kind of miracle, waiting so long. I've been waiting so long. He's soft to the touch, but frayed at the ends he breaks. He's never enough, and still he's more than I can take. Oh, and I don't know what he's after, but he's so beautiful. He's such a beautiful disaster. And if I could hold on through the tears and the laughter, Lord, would it be beautiful or just a beautiful disaster? He's beautiful. Oh, he's so beautiful. Oh, he's beautiful. Thank you, guys. I'm just gonna take
take this last sip of water right here. This next song has a little bit more of an R&B kind of a feel to it. I personally like singing a lot of different styles of music because it represents who I'd like to be as an artist. So this song is called Say You Love Me by Jessie Ware.
Say you love me to my face. I'm even more than your embrace. Just say you want me, that's all it takes. Heart's getting torn from your mistakes. 'Cause I don't wanna fall in love if you don't wanna try. But all that I've been thinking of is maybe that you might. And baby, looks as though we're just for today, and don't give me time, 'cause that's not the same. Oh, one, two, three, burning flames when you say my name. Want to feel passion flow into my bones like blood through my veins. 'Cause I don't wanna fall in love if you don't wanna try. But all that I've been thinking of is maybe that you might. And baby, looks as though we're running out of words to say. The love's floating away. Alternative thing.
The song is by Evanescence, one of my favorite bands. This one was popular back in, I want to say 2006. This is Call Me When You're Sober.
Don't cry to me if you love me. You would be here with me. You want me, come find me. Make up your mind. Did I let you fall?
In that bottle there, some vodka. God, she wishes.
She, yeah, see that? Hey,
oh man,
where are you going to town? Come on, sit down, lady.
All right.
So, tell everybody your name so we can. I'm terrible with names.
Natasha Rodriguez.
Yes.
All right, you got it.
I got it right.
And she's drinking water.
Water.
Yeah.
How'd you get started in singing?
Oh, man. I've always loved to sing as long as I can remember, to be honest. And it all started when, you know, I was in chorus all the way back in elementary school, I guess.
Wow.
Like,
okay.
I just, by the time I got to high school, or middle school, really, I started doing all county chorus. I got into an upper choir within Pine Bush High School, and it's always just pushing to sing. When I got in college, I started having vocal coaches here and there, and I I also had a vocal class a couple times, so I was training with a, you know, a small setting with a professor, so that was really nice. And
well, I had two brothers that sang, and they were my vocal coach. They told me, get out of the house and don't come back. Country is a different style. You're singing it's through totally, your nose, more or less.
Oh, I see.
But along the lines, though, I did learn how to sing with my diaphragm because I was in a choir also.
Right. My vocal coach now tells me to, you know, it's in the diaphragm.
Yeah, right.
Well, you last longer if you sing from your down there.
Right, yeah.
So
right,
and
Phil,
how did you meet? I'm sorry, yeah.
25 years.
Wow.
And how did you meet? You met at where?
I believe at TGIF.
Yes.
Right.
Oh, wow.
My job.
Oh, no. Funny.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
At karaoke there, yeah. Because I like to go with some of my coworkers, and
it's
fun,
right?
It's a lot of fun.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's
well, see, okay. Now, when you get your songs recorded, then you can start bringing them around karaoke. If you record, make sure you get tracks that are karaoke also.
Right.
Don't just get like a finished record. You get that. Mm-hmm. You get a karaoke version. Because if you start getting a lot of songs, somebody might want to sing them. And you could say, yeah, you could sing it. It's going to cost you.
That's a good point. Yeah.
You know, because it's all business, the whole thing. You know, so you like singing? What'd you say? You want to get a guitar player or something?
Yes. I write lyrics now. I have melodies in my head. I've been writing songs since I was like 12. Like I was
You poor girl,
on the school
it's in your
bus.
Blood now. You're done.
Right, that's right.
Yes, but unfortunately I don't play an instrument, and that is something that I want to look forward to doing.
To doing, right.
Yeah, it'll be easier, but for now, I would like to find a guitarist or somebody who knows piano just to.
Anybody out there listening, she's looking for a guitarist.
That's right, yes.
Someone who's down to just put out like
a
different
pro,
sounding
not
music.
Not just somebody that just jams.
Right.
And,
who's along for the run and likes that.
Does
fun.
It bother you to sing in front of a lot of people? Or
makes me nervous. Okay. Yeah, I mean, but you know, as when you get into it and stuff, it goes a little better. But I used to get stage fright a little bit, like doing the talent show, like when I was a senior in high school.
Right.
I forgot the lyrics after a little bit. I was
when I opened for Willie Nelson, it was 8,000 people, and that was my blood pressure must have been through the roof.
That's right. That's right. Well,
you
know
so
what?
Wound up and you know.
Right.
Get it.
Right.
And honestly, I think that it's good to get a little bit of the jitters because basically you're getting that because you want to do good.
I wasn't born with jitters.
That's true.
I'm telling you, my brothers couldn't stand it because they had to get drunk and drink and everything before they sang.
Uh-huh.
And it never bothered me. I make it like a checker game. I want to see if I can get the audience wound up.
Yeah.
Right.
And when my wife's sitting there, once I know I got them, I'll go like this. You know what that means?
In the palm of my hand.
I got him in the palm of my hand. I'm just an up person, so it's my brother said, you don't even drink. I said, you don't have to drink. Yeah. My high is the people.
Right.
Yeah, exactly.
Right.
Like, I realized that like the first time, you know, I did the talent show back in high school. I went to Pine Bush High School, really big, like 2,000 students.
Yeah, we know where that is,
a couple hundred within that crowd that night. And the energy that threw back at me, I was high for days.
Right.
Yeah,
it's true. It really is true. Yeah,
it was
such
a great crowd.
Yeah.
And I'll never forget that.
Yeah.
Well, I took her, she took me and my wife, and we went to see Don, and we had a great time.
Oh, we had
and
a fantastic
like I wanted
time.
To tell her was... Since I've had my own band for years, couple different guys, we played 2,000 gigs.
Mm.
And every time it was a party like that.
Right,
so I have nothing to complain about. It was always fun and always a great time.
Right, right. That's well.
Plus,
that's
the wives and women went off the rocker because they were all drinking back then.
Well, you know, they're sitting around.
And
they got nothing, you know.
I gave up doing Elvis because some girl ripped my shirt in half. I just... Couldn't handle that.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
I'm going to guess that there might have been a lot of fights breaking out from band members' wives and stuff like that for all the women coming on to their men.
Oh man.
Right?
Well, there's all that stuff going on.
Yeah, there's always, there's got to be, you know.
Yeah, when somebody rips your shirt off and jumps on your leg and rides like a dog, you know you're in trouble.
Yeah, I would say so.
Because I used to do a little bit of an Elvis act because I could actually copy his later years voice.
Right.
Nice.
And she says, I'll hit her with a chair. I says, that's the end of Elvis. Yeah.
Well, I got to tell you, you got one in a million there. Lois is a good egg for doing this all these years.
Yeah.
You know, because being
she knows all the words, everything I'm singing. That's right. I watch her. She's going like this. I can see her singing.
Right. Of course.
And when I was young, she thought I looked like Elvis.
I know you said, yeah, well, I could take
it. She fell in love with Elvis, I took advantage of it. Put my blue suede shoes and everything was great.
Yeah, that's right.
But you never know when you're playing whatever's going on in the club. As a singer, you're going to find out. Even when we used to always go to the diner after something. Yeah. We didn't go this time.
Mm-hmm.
Donna wouldn't know if she went or not.
I was not.
You was eating that lady's food and everything. I was like, hold on.
No.
You and Lois, not just you. Wow. Everybody there is going, where's the party? That woman over there is.
We had a good time. We had a ball.
You were dancing. Yeah. Don plays everything.
Yeah.
You know, she's been having fun. Like.
Oh, yeah. You know what? But I was not sloppy.
She wasn't.
I was not sloppy.
She wasn't.
Okay, I was.
Wasted. No, she wasn't drunk or nothing.
No.
Just enough to have a good time.
Just happy. Right. Yeah. Happy. We had a lot of fun. And I will say because the place is tiny, it's not real big.
No, it was packed though.
But it was packed.
Elbow room only.
Yeah, and so sitting was a real luxury there. And I spotted this table.
Somebody else's table?
Well, and so Lois and I sat down, and I was thinking of Lois, because, Lois has the hip that's bothering her. And they weren't coming back. I mean, I said, well, we'll sit here. If they come back, we'll get up and we'll leave. That's all.
Out through this window. Here they are munching on sandwiches and stuff. Wait, Donna must have sprung for something to eat. It wasn't even ours.
No, what happened was there was a bag of chips. And so I was like, Lois, you want a chip?
Listen, I had a guitar player. We used to go every time to the diner. I used to bring 250 people in Monroe Diner.
Oh, my gosh.
I never paid for dinner or nothing there because I brought so many people there. Wow. But this one guy I know who played guitar for me, he was a wise guy with the waitresses. So she said, what do you want? He goes, I want a glass of milk. And he'd always say, it's a dirty cup, I don't want it. No matter what, it was nothing wrong.
Jeez, oh no.
So then she said, well, what do you want to eat? And he goes, I want a rubber band sandwich and make it snappy. She went in the back and rolled up some bread, put a rubber band on it, brought the plate out.
Good
goes,
for her.
Here you go. Oh,
that's good. Oh. Good for her.
Yeah, I'm a server, so I know those pains.
You know those, right. That's right.
Where do you serve?
Oh,
where do you
goodness.
Work?
I work at TGI Fridays.
Oh, you do?
Oh,
okay.
Yeah, that's good, yeah.
Walk Hill, Crystal Run, yeah.
Okay.
Whatever.
Oh, all right.
Yeah.
Okay. So,
Wednesday night.
Oh, yeah. Sometimes, I just, right when I get off my shift, I'd bring a change of clothes and hop right to karaoke.
Hop out of the karaoke.
Right in the bar area.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
Wow.
Oh, that's
yeah.
Right. Wow.
And that place usually has a nice crowd, too.
Yeah.
Usually.
Yeah.
Wow.
Well, it's good to hear you sing and stuff.
Yeah.
Thank you.
As you noticed, the first time you're up, a little bit nervous, and then now when you go up, you're going to be relaxed.
Right,
and you're going
to
kick butt. It was good already, but you'll kick butt. That's all.
I hope so.
Well, there's over 6 million viewers that's going to see this.
Yeah. Not to get you nervous.
I don't
anything.
Bother you. It's just they're in the camera. Right. They're only in the camera. Hi, everybody. This is her right here.
Yeah, so we have to give a shout out. Hi, Benzie.
Benzie Bullville. He lives up
Bullville.
By Pine Bush.
That was the co-host.
Past
co-host.
Oh, and not to change the subject, I got one of my old co-hosts is going to sing with me.
Oh.
At my next gig.
Oh.
Chrissy Lee.
Oh. Okay.
This?
Over in Route 6 in Greenville. And she plays the guitar and the banjo and keyboards. Nice. So
when is this gonna be?
November something. But I just show up. My wife pokes me and says, "You got to go to the gig."
Yeah, this is.
And yeah.
I remember her. She was She was your co-host when I first started.
Well, she's the one that sang One Red Rose, the high end.
Oh.
She got angel voice. But she can do anything, old-time rock and roll. And
really? Yeah. Wow.
So we're going to have a rehearsal with her just to get some songs.
Oh, good.
Wow.
And then we're not getting rid of Sue. Sue's, when she can make it, she'll come. But I really need the extra person to round the band out.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then I'm going to try to get Don Oriole, if I'm saying it right.
Oriolo.
Oriolo. Boy, Don. I'm going to try to get him to do something with his band and my band, like a two-band bash, and we'll open for his band.
That'll be great. Yeah.
And it'll be one big damn jam.
Oh, my jamming. Oh, my gosh.
Fun with those. I remember back in the 90s at Deer Park Family Festival and the Orange County Fair on a Sunday afternoon. All day.
Yeah.
Well, Orange County Fair this year, well, I passed it over to Bob Keegan, who's going to be running it this year.
Oh.
Because I had enough. And he's a good guy. He's not a backstabber. He does good sound. And he has a great band. So
right. We
wanted to do something different this year to end my time with the fair. So we had two drummers, three guitar players, myself, bass, and... We tore that place up. We was doing Freebird and everything. It was great.
That's a good one, yeah.
Wish I could have gone.
Well, most country bands you see around don't have double drummers and stuff.
Right.
Oh, okay.
Now they don't, yeah. Because
I'm like mixed into rock and country, you know, so it's
nice.
The way it goes. And listen, I pledge a flag. I don't kneel in the dirt for anybody except God. So I listen to these things, and I'm not political, because they have the right to do whatever they want. But don't do it on that venue. Go out on TV shows, go do all that and get it out there. Because there's a lot of mad veterans out there, and I love the veterans and support the veterans and all the soldiers and stuff, and that's a real letdown. I know a lot of people don't even want to watch NFL no more.
Right. Listen, we got 10 minutes.
10 minutes,
Yep.
That means you're going to be singing. Listen, I appreciate you coming down eating some hot dogs with us.
Thank you.
You're
very
welcome
nice
anytime.
To meet you, Natasha.
You too.
And if you get any CDs done, you're welcome to have a release party here on my show.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
That would be amazing. I'm good for four songs, or should I?
Whatever you got, just
whatever,
go.
Whatever, yeah, just,
it.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's
go just
for
Donna
it.
Talk too much.
Okay. Congratulations on New England.
Thank you, Giants.
Yeah.
Eli's coming.
Oh, boy.
At least they won't be in there to beat us in the Super Bowl. All right, go ahead and introduce her, Phil. Wake up. He's sleeping. Oh, he's sleeping over here.
My Giants lost again. 3 in a row, folks.
That's just too bad.
I want to once again introduce my great friend, Natasha Rodriguez.
All right.
Hey, guys. So this next song I'll be singing is called Ghost by Ella Henderson.
I keep going to the river to pray, 'cause I need something that can wash out the pain. And at most, I'm sweeping all these demons away. But your ghost, the ghost of you, it keeps me awake. My friends, have you figured out? Yeah, they saw what's inside of you. You tried hiding another you, but your evil is coming through. And these eyes sitting on the wall, well, they watch every move I make. Bright eye living in the shade, you cold heart like a spirit shade. Ooh, I had to go through hell to prove I'm not insane. Had to meet the devil just to know his name. And that's when my love was burning. Yeah, it's still burning. I keep going to the river to pray, 'cause I need something that can wash out the pain. And I know I'm sleeping all these demons away, but your ghost, the ghost of you, it keeps me awake. I keep going to the river to pray, 'cause I need something that can wash out the pain. The ghost of you, it keeps me awake.
Each time that I think you're gone, I turn around and you're creeping in. And I let you into my skin, cause I love living in the sin. Oh, you never told me true love was gonna hurt, true pain I don't deserve, true things that I never learned. I keep going to the river to pray, cause I need something that can wash out the pain. And I know I'm sleeping all these demons away, but your ghost, the ghost of you, it keeps me awake. I keep going to the river to pray, cause I need something that can wash out the pain. And I know I'm sleeping all these demons away, but your ghost, the ghost of you, it keeps me awake. Give up the ghost, give up the ghost, give up the ghost, stop the haunting, baby. Give up the ghost, give up the ghost, give up the ghost, no more haunting, baby. I'm actually gonna go ahead and skip to Good Enough. It's another song by Evanescence, and it's very, very pretty, and I hope you enjoy it.
Now I
can't let go of this dream. I can't believe that I feel good enough. I feel good enough. It's been such a long time coming, but I feel good.
Guys, I'm sorry about that. I think all that power, that work in my voice today. All right, this last song is the song that I actually performed in the talent show when I was a senior in high school in Pine Bush. And this one I regularly perform at karaoke events. It's called If I Ain't Got You by Alicia Keys. And thank you very much for having me. Yeah. Some people search for fortune. Some people live just for the fame. Some people live for the power. Yeah, yeah. Some people live just to play the game. Some people think that the physical things define what's within. I've been there before, but that life's a bore. It's so full of the superficial. Some people want it all, but I don't want nothing at all. If but everything means nothing if I ain't got you. Yeah, yeah. Some people search for a fountain that promises forever young. You know, some people need 3 dozen roses.